House Leader, Third Party.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Yesterday evening, after we adjourned, I rushed out of here, as many of us are inclined to do, and headed out to the theatre at Tillicum to catch the screening of Sharkwater, Extinction. On the way over, I was listening to CBC's As It Happens. The host was interviewing Brad Lister, biologist and lead author of a recently released report on data collected in the El Yunque rainforest in Costa Rica. Lister was recounting the difference between his first visit to the rainforest in the 1970s and his return nearly 40 years later. He described the rainforest as enchanted, a timeless, phantasmagorical world, but when he went back in 2013, he was devastated to discover that there were no butterflies. Then he realized it wasn't just butterflies that were missing. There had been, in his words, a catastrophic implosion of the insect community. The food web of the rainforest, explained Lister, was gone. Butterflies, insects, birds, lizards, frogs, all gone. Sharkwater extinction was no less chilling. 90% of sharks have been fished out of our oceans in the last 30 years, and many species are at risk of disappearing forever. 90% in 30 years. Globally, 150 million sharks are being killed each year. Sharks have survived on the Earth for 450 million years through five mass extinctions, but over 30 years, humans have nearly wiped them out completely. Rob Stewart, who died tragically during a dive while making the film, said that initially his research into the plight of sharks made him feel disappointed with humanity, but that the response to his first Sharkwater film changed that. It instilled hope, he said. It made me love humanity more. We still have a bright future if we want it, but we've got to do something now. It was a sobering evening, but I choose to heed Rob's wise words and believe that we can still create that bright future if we truly want to.